Recently, the UOB YOLO Card has been revamped to form the UOB EVOL Card, and the Citibank SMRT Card has been renamed to the Citi SMRT Card with a brand new set of minimum spend requirements. So in this video, I'll go through the full analysis and my spending strategies for these two cashback credit cards that comes with minimum spend for you so that you don't have to. What's up guys, it's Christopher back here at Hardy Money SG. And in this channel, we are all about building financial knowledge, teach money saving hacks, and also help you lead a fulfilling quality of life. So like I said in my previous credit card videos, with higher spend come higher rewards. And this is exactly the case that we want to discuss today. Credit cards with minimum spending requirements are expected to gain higher cashback rewards than no minimum spend credit cards because of the extra effort to track them and also maximize your spending. And most likely, if you do not hit the minimum spend, you will not get any form of cashback or rewards at all. Some of the existing minimum spend credit cards include the DBS Live Fresh, OCBC Frank, and the two cards being discussed today, the UOB EVOL Card and the Citi SMRT credit card. Now let's start off with the UOB EVOL Card. The existing YOLO card will only be effective till the 16th of June 2021. And I remember I used to have this card a few years back because it was eligible for GrabPay wallet top-ups, but not anymore. So that card used to give you 8% cashback on your weekend dining and entertainment, Grab transactions, and also the UOB travel. And then gives you 3% cashback for the same category if you spend it during the weekdays, as well as online fashion and online spend. It also gives you 0.3% cashback on all other spend that are not listed above. So it's kind of confusing because when you want to use this card, you have to think about whether it is a weekday or weekend, and that it will affect your spending pattern. To me, this card is not optimized for usage because it is just too confusing and troublesome to track it. So right now we have the new EVOL card, which is effective from 17 June 2021. Your existing YOLO card will be transformed to the new EVOL card. And let's take a look at what EVOL cashback card gives you. You have 8% cashback on all online spend, including dining, entertainment, shopping, fashion, Grab, hotels and more. And also 8% on your mobile contactless transactions, including via Apple Pay, Google Pay and Samsung Pay. So take note, this is mobile contactless spend, not by just card PayWave. And then similarly, you get 0.3% on all your other spend. So there's a cashback cap of $60 per month, and it's separated by $20 online spend and $20 mobile contactless spend and $20 for your other spend. So now let's discuss how you can use your UOB EVOL card better to maximize your spending. One thing to note is that to be eligible for cashback, you need to have a minimum spend of $600 per month. And in order to max out your $20 online and $20 mobile contactless cashback, this is the spend that you need to have. So we use $20 divided by 8%, we will get $250 of spend for each category to get the maximized cashback. So that means we need to spend $250 online, $250 on mobile contactless payments, and that will total up to $500 spent to get back $40 cashback. So we are left with $100 of remaining spend, right? So then we have to spend this $100 on all your other kind of spend. You can use the $100 to top up your EZLink or your NetFlashPay card to pay your car park fees, or even use it to pay insurance if your insurance company accepts it, or use the $100 to just top up to your GrabPay digital wallet. But because it's just 0.3% cashback, right, you will just get 30 cents for spending $100 on it. So your total cashback gotten from this UOB EVOL card is actually $40.30 for spending $600, and your effective cashback is only 6.7%, not like the advertised 8%, which is still a good cashback percentage if you ask me. 6.7% in a month, that's just really good. Now let's move on to my next card, which is the Citi SMRT credit card. The existing card is called the Citibank SMRT card, and then it will be renamed to Citi SMRT card, which is valid until 24th of May 2021. And the old reward system is like this. You have 5% cashback on your grocery spend, including your NTUC at Kallang. That gives you 7.3% on Kallang Wave FairPrice Extra. You get 5% cashback on fast food, movies and coffee, and then 3% savings on online shopping. And if you did not hit that minimum spend of $300 per month, you will only get 0.3% less cashback. That means 4.7% on your grocery spending, for example, which is not too much if you ask me, given that it has a no minimum spend requirement last time. But now, with the Citi SMRT card effective from 25th of May 2021, it will introduce a minimum spend requirement of $500. So the eligible categories also change to groceries, online spend, EZ-Link auto top-ups, and Simply Go, taxi and private hire rides. So the grocery and online shopping categories are still there, but the fast food, movies and coffee categories are all removed. And then now you need to spend minimum $500 to get that minimum cashback. So now let's discuss how I will use a Citi SMRT card if I'm interested. Now with this $500 minimum spend, you want to only spend in those categories that are eligible for the 5% cashback. So this table that I show here is an example of how I will spend it in a month in order to hit every eligible category with this Citi SMRT card. So I'll spend a total of $500, and with the 5% cashback, that gives me $25 back per month. Wrapping up, let me give me my thoughts on the new enhancement or revamp of these two credit cards. To me, I felt that the EVOL card is a good enhancement to the existing YOLO card because it gives a much higher percent cashback, even though the effective cashback is only 6.7%. But the categories and the spending requirements are fairly easy to hit and nothing too confusing compared to the weekday, weekend spending requirements and all that nonsense. Minimum spend is still capped at $600, which has not increased in a good way. So I felt that the EVOL card is a good addition to your cashback credit cards if you do not own one yet. For Citi SMRT card, my reaction is a mix. I felt that when they remove the minimum spend requirements, it's much of a downgrade because now it's either 5% or nothing. But the good thing about it is that it expanded your online spend category from 3% to 5% cashback. So for people who mostly spend online on their Citi SMRT card, I believe that it's a good upgrade. Of course, all these things depend on your spending pattern, and everyone's spending pattern is really unique to their own personal lives. The most important thing is to pay your bill on time and don't incur rolling interest on your credit cards. Like I said before, don't be penny wise to earn that small cashback and be pound foolish by rolling up the interest and then incurring huge credit card debts. Do leave your comments down below if you want to see more reviews of cashback credit cards or even miles credit card for that matter, right? Or also reviews of existing cards like DBS Live Fresh or OCBC Frank. I will answer to each and every of your comments as long as it is not a hate comment or negativity. And also spam bots, I know you are there. Don't trust them, don't go to your Telegram groups or whatever and then get spam of your money. So if you have enjoyed this content today, do give a like and share this video to your friends and family, and also subscribe to the channel because I will have more up and coming content like this. Do check out my earlier videos on how you can maximize your spending and also your road to financial retirement. My name is Christopher, this is Honey Money SG, steering young adults to financial independence.